Faith Copeland. I'm an artist, and I'd like to tell you a little bit about my work and show you afterwards some of my paintings. I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I grew up in the United States outside of Boston, and my family now live in Florida. But I've been in Europe for many years. I lived in France and Spain, a little bit in Italy and Austria, and then I went to Sweden, where I took a degree in art history. But I always have been painting and always wanted to work as an artist. So I came over to Copenhagen, and there's many possibilities for exhibitions. I've been working as an artist for the last 20 years here in Copenhagen, arranging many, many exhibitions for myself and for groups. One of the most recent one was in Tinghus Gallery. It's up in Fredensborg. It's an old prison that's more like a castle, and it's been converted to gallery. Each artist has a cell. The name of the painting that you saw behind me is Galleria Vittorio Emanuele. This is a very famous passageway, very elegant, in Milan. And right behind it, you saw the cathedral. And as you noticed in the foreground, there was a young couple, very romantic, holding hands, and ready is their mobile phone. And you'll see all the many citizens in the background running around with their mobile phones. There's been a lot of research that the mobile phones can be damaging, but the people don't care. They just buy more and more mobile phones. This technique I chose especially because the painting is in Italy and there's so many famous and beautiful frescoes in the churches. It's something like the technique of the frescoes. In Denmark you have kalkmaleri. And in this technique they're using, and I used egg as the binding material. I used the pigments in powder form, and then I dip it in the egg yolk. Then I put a little bit of linseed oil to make it go smoother. What is typical of this technique is that the surface is rather dull. After several months of drying, it becomes very hard and can last for hundreds of years, like the frescoes in the Italian churches or the kalkmaleri in the Danish churches that you saw just before this demonstration. The second painting is called Seagulls Watching the Sunrise. It's done in acrylic on canvas, and it's a typical, beautiful summer morning. I did it in a town about an hour out of Copenhagen called Korsør. I had a friend who had a house right on the water, and each year she would invite me for a week to come and do paintings. She was a very wonderful, kind person. Unfortunately, she's not living anymore, and I miss her a lot. So I had a wonderful week by the sea, and my room was under the roof with a slanting window that I could see the stars at night and see shooting stars. It was a beautiful experience. Then in the morning, about 4 o'clock, it starts getting light in the beautiful Scandinavian summer, and I could open the window, push it up, and look directly on the sea. See beautiful sunrise. Here you see the seagulls watching the sunrise. I love animals and I identify with them. So I'm watching the sun and the seagulls are watching. We're one and the same. So you see the clouds and the reflection in the water. Thank you. This next painting, on the contrary, is a winter scene, also in Denmark. Denmark is made up of many islands, and they're very, very beautiful, very, very special. And one island is called Ære. This painting is done on Ære and impressed me very much the way the sound, the land between the island and the mainland was frozen over, and it was breaking up in small pieces that gave a beautiful pattern. You can see in the middle of the painting some swans. They didn't fly south, they chose to stay, and they found a little spot that was melted. And again, you see the birds, they're looking out on the landscape, just as I am. And they're singing. The whole island, even in winter, is full of bird song. I would always go out in the morning and listen to the beautiful melodies of the many birds. Now you see, everything is covered with ice. They call it rimfrost hair. There's like a coating of white frost over everything, giving a magical effect. You see, the trees are looking like lollipops, completely white. The fourth painting is from the Faroe Islands. There's some islands near Scotland that belong to Denmark. I've made many trips up there. They're very, very beautiful. I'm very crazy about islands. I feel very happy when I'm on an island and very safe. And I love the puffins. I identify with them. Maybe I was a puffin in my last life. You can see the puffins in the foreground and they're admiring the sunset. You see the clouds very low to the horizon. This is typical on the north part of the earth. You'll see that, note the reflections. You'll see some fishing boats in the background. The Faroe Islands, there are many, many fish in the northern seas, and the people from the Faroes, they live from fish. They also have sheep. That's the name of the islands, got the name from sheep, farming sheep. In Scandinavian, you can see some small sheep on the land. Was an American friend, and the child was a typical teenager. She didn't want to be in the country. That was poison for her. She just wanted to run around in the city with her friends. So you can see she has a very sour face. She just hid in the room, and her comfort was this beautiful white cat that they had. But then at the end of the weekend, when we all went back to the city, she began to love the place, and she said, "No, I'm staying here." So it was a very interesting change. This painting is done in the technique of egg tempera that I explained before. You can see the softness, the matte surface, which is typical of the egg tempera. And this is done on the island of Ære, another beautiful Danish island. But this time the season is springtime. You can tell by the tulips just beginning to bud. I named the painting Tulip Hearts because they look like small hearts. You can see a woman in the back hanging her clothes up. You see the tree in bloom. It's the springtime is beautiful with the rose pink blossoms. It's probably an apple tree. Blowing, the sky is gray. You can see a typical historic windmill. There are several of them on the island. Denmark is very big in wind power, but the modern ones are not as beautiful as the old ones. Then you see the horse on the island. There are many beautiful horses there. This painting I call Big Puffins. I've made a lot of paintings of the puffins. I love them. I've done it in the Faroe Islands and also in Iceland. And you can see that the technique is acrylic on a masonite board. You see the puffins looking out to sea. And in the background you can see the small green islands. The Faroe Islands is made up of many small islands. You can see the fishing boats and you can see the small clouds. You can see many bright colors in the skies, pink and orange and yellow. In the Faroe Islands, it's very colorful. I call this painting Swell Party because sometimes you go to a party after you've had a full few drinks and the others have had a few drinks. People begin to look like different types of animals, their character. You see up in the right corner someone that's like a butterfly flitting around, a woman that has a stinger on the back like a bee, and then you see another man that's like a vicious piranha, and another one like a mellow turtle or a walrus. People often ask me, who is your favorite artist? Who inspires you? Many people have said that I seem to be inspired by Chagall. Of course, I do like Chagall. And others have said Dufy. And others have said Rousseau. But actually, my favorite artist is Matisse. For me, he's purity and cleanness and so much. He captures things the way I would love to be able to do it. His whole life he made beautiful paintings, even when he was full of arthritis and had to just cut out shapes. They were beautiful, in my opinion, and in many other people's opinion. These photos are from the town of Oaxaca. a beautiful Moorish town, all in white, by the sea, on a mountaintop. It's a lovely Spanish town in the province of Almeria, in Andalusia. And in this town, there is a foundation called Valparaiso. It was founded by a Danish man, Paul Beckett, who, in order to support the arts, he bought an old mill, a flour mill, and he kept it in the old style but renovated it so you're comfortable. And the artist gets a studio with a balcony overlooking the mountains and the sea, and you're just free to do your work. The only thing is, at the end, you're supposed to show what you've accomplished. And the foundation invites many people from the town, the mayor and other important people, to come to this reception. And then each one presents what they did during this time. So I made an exhibition in my room with all the paintings I made. And some of them I still have. Some of them I've sold. And you can see a few of them. First painting is called Barking Dogs, and you can see why. All the dogs are barking in chorus. When I looked out of my window, I saw this beautiful Moorish white town with the sea in the background, with the orange trees and lemon trees, and all these barking dogs singing in chorus. The next painting I call Magic Mountain, because we always referred to it as the Magic Mountain. Paul Beckett, who founded the Valparaiso, he was an archaeologist. This town was very interesting. Archaeologically, there were many, many layers of different civilizations. And this is the view from the terrace behind the foundation. You can see the red tiles, the orange tiles of the terrace. And then in the background, you see the Magic Mountain and the sea and the white Moorish houses. The flowering trees are almond trees. I was there in March and it was something spectacular. This is another view from the terrace. You can see the sea in the background and the red and orange earth. This is the fourth painting. I call it Hanging Oranges, or sometimes Mountain Ride. You can see Paul Beckett's wife and a friend taking a ride in the mountains. They had many horses. The town was founded around a spring with lovely water. Even now there's running water, but we still went to lovely water, and we had this spring water in the foundation. In the background, a gardener working, and you see the goats and the goat herder, and up in the right corner you see the donkey. In this painting, I call it Hanging Lemons. It was something spectacular. The oranges and lemons were hanging so heavy and beautifully all over the town. We would go and get fresh oranges and press it every morning. You can see the donkey on the right, and the gardener and the cats also giving a serenade, and then the town, the white boxes, Moorish influence. The next series is a series of watercolors. This is one of my favorite mediums. The way you make watercolors, usually we buy them already made, but it's pigments in powder and they're mixed with gum arabic. And the most characteristic of watercolors is the transparency. They're transparent, you can see the paper through. That's what gives it a beautiful brilliance and liveliness. The first one is from Tivoli Gardens. The tulips are spectacular every spring. They have a wonderful gardener, and he makes the most exotic, strange, beautiful tulips and patterns throughout the garden. You can see the fountains, the small basins. The next painting is from Faroe Islands. They have very, very famous boats. They're like Viking boats. Every Faroese person has their own boat. You can see how beautiful they are and they're reflecting in the water. This is done in the harbor of Tórshavn, the capital city. We'll continue with the watercolors. I'll show you a few more. Here are some paintings that I did in Denmark in a foundation. It's the same idea as Valparaiso, but it's in Denmark. It's in North Zealand. It's in Hornbæk, deep in the forest. It's like a paradise. If you get accepted, you get a little house for yourself, but it's primitive. You have to chop wood and go fetch your own water. But it's really like a paradise. It's incredibly beautiful and inspiring. So the first painting, you see me sitting out painting. With some small colorful ponies and butterflies. This painting, as you can see, it's the fall. I was in Revis gifted several years, and each time a different month. This was in the autumn. You can see the trees are beginning to lose their leaves, and you see the red squirrels on the left, and you see the deer in the forest. And on the right, you see the wild roses. This was the view from the front of my house. If I woke up very early in the morning, I could see the deers come out to eat their breakfast. The next one, I woke up in the middle of the night because the moon was so bright. It was a full moon, and I went out in the darkness. Well, it wasn't very dark because the moon was so bright. And the owner of Revis Gifted has small ponies. So I went to visit the ponies, and the moonlight was shining on them, and it was the most beautiful experience. They were looking at me, and I was looking at them. I was completely spellbound. It was an extraordinary evening. A supernatural experience with a full moon. Now I'd like to go on next and show you something completely different. It's a different technique. It's painting on silk. This is a series of four paintings. These have been exhibited in the American Embassy in Copenhagen, in the Italian Cultural Institute in Copenhagen, and the theater in Slagelse. Now I'd like to show you just briefly a little bit about the technique. It's kind of a batik technique. I have a frame, a wooden frame, and I have thumbtacks, and of course a piece of silk that I stretch, try to make it tight, and I press it into the wood. The wood is quite soft, so it accepts the tack. Try to make it as tight as you can. Because when the water comes on, it gets loose again. You could also use a box and use tape, but I prefer to use a wooden frame. I'm going to make a quick drawing on the silk. The difference is that with the batik, you're using wax, but we're using glue. In this case, I'm using a water-soluble glue that I'll wash out afterwards. This painting is inspired by an Icelandic poet that I met in Spain, Hallgrímur Helgason. He was always dressed in black, so this is him sitting on the beach with all his books, and a little seagull is watching him attentively. Now we've waited 15 minutes for the glue to dry, so I'm able to apply the color. It's a special kind of paint, acrylic-based, and it's made specially for painting on silk. It gives a watercolor effect, so I'm using water to dilute it. The more water, the lighter it gets, because it's mixing with the white of the color of the silk. You can see the salt is giving a special effect. It's absorbing the paint. And I also sprinkled water on it. It gives a special effect also, making sparks and making it very lively. The heat from the iron fixes the color, so you could wash it. The color won't wash out. This is an ancient Chinese art. Then after this, I'll wash it and get all the glue out of it. When the silk is finished, there are several ways of presenting it. Some people mount it on a foam board, and then other people put it behind glass in a frame. And then there's another school that prefers to have the silk hanging freely so that it shows the true character of the silk and it's vibrating in the wind, like in the series of the four paintings you will see now. The first one is gladiolas. You saw the red flowers with the birds singing. The next one is white lilies, and you also see some hummingbirds around. And the next one is open sea. You see the little pink clouds. I painted it on a boat. I took a freight ship each summer up to the Faroe Islands. And when I went out in the early morning, I could see beautiful skies with small pink clouds and the sunset or the sunrise. Then the last one is from Iceland, which is one of my favorite places. You see the beautiful black lava beach. You see the stones, they're covered with moss. There are no trees in Iceland. Then there are the Arctic terns, and you see the sulfur red hills. Thank you.
My family was never happy that I decided to be an artist, but I'm very happy with it. I guess they just thought it would be too hard for me economically. Well, I haven't got much money, but I'm very happy with my art, and I hope you enjoyed it. This was just a small part of my very, very large collection. If you want to see more, you're welcome to visit my home site, www.faithcopeland.com. Thank you for your kind attention.